Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Mathematics class for Standard 6th, Chapter 14, Practical Geometry, Part 2. Students, in this video we will be continuing with the constructions which are there in this chapter. Okay students, so let us begin. Let us begin with perpendicular to a line through a point not on it. Okay, in the earlier video I taught you about the perpendicular drawn to a line with the help or with a point which was on the line. In this construction, you are going to learn that how to construct a perpendicular line through a point which is not on the line, which is somewhere outside, maybe up, maybe down. Okay, so let us draw one line of any length. Okay, and this is a line which is of any length. So what we are going to do now, take a point which is not on the line. So suppose this is the point which is not on the line. Okay students, so now how to draw a perpendicular through this point to this line segment. Okay, what you're going to do, take the compass and the pencil attached to it. What you're going to do, you're going to put this needle here on the point which is outside the line, and from this point you have to make a perpendicular to this line segment. So take the needle and put there on the point. Okay, and then you have to increase the length of this compass so that it should go beyond the line like this. Okay, when it is little above the line, you have to cut the line segment like this on both the side. Understood? So now you are going to get two intersecting points, one here and one here. Okay, now without changing the length of this radius, it is called radius. Okay, without changing the length of pointer and the pencil, you are going to keep this needle or the pointer on the intersecting point of the arc and the line segment we just now drawn. You have to make right one arc at the center. Okay, right in the middle of these two arc, you have to make one more arc. Now again, without changing the length of the pencil and the pointer, you have to change the intersecting point. Earlier it was this, now the second. Without changing it, you are going to intersect the same arc and you are going to get one new point here. Okay, now what you are going to do, you are going to join this point with this point. So let us join. You have to be very accurate while taking the point because you have to keep a little distance so that you can keep your point of the pencil right on the intersecting point. Okay, and then you have to draw the line like this. So what you have drawn? You have drawn one perpendicular through a point which was outside the line, and this perpendicular is to this line segment. Understood? So this is how you are going to construct a perpendicular to a line through a point which is not on it. I hope student you understood how to construct this. Students, the construction does not come only with the pencils and this thing. You have to only draw and show it. No, not at all. What you are going to do, you after construction you have to write the steps of construction also. Okay student, but as this chapter is deleted, I'm just showing you the way how to construct it. Okay, writing thing definitely you're going to learn the next year, sure. Okay, now let us move ahead. The next topic is perpendicular bisector of a line segment. Now you're going to draw a perpendicular bisector. Now what is the difference between a perpendicular to a line and a perpendicular bisector of the line? Now when you draw a line perpendicular, that means the line is like this and anywhere you can draw a 90 degree like this. The line is not sure to be at the center of the given line segment. Okay, students. So what does a perpendicular bisector means? Perpendicular bisector means to any given line. If you are drawing one another line which is perpendicular to that line, so it is called perpendicular, but as well as it bisects the given line. Now what do you mean by bisect? Bisect means to cut the given line segment into two equal parts, into two equal halves. Then it is called as perpendicular bisector. Now let us draw it. Take any line segment of your choice. If the length is mentioned for you, you have to take that particular length only. But suppose if mention is not there, then you are going to take the length of your choice. Okay, so here is one line segment. Suppose I am taking one line segment of 10 centimeter. Okay, now this 10 centimeter line I have taken. I have to draw a perpendicular bisector of this line. So what you are going to do, you are going to make use of the compass and the pencil, of course. Okay, put your pointer of the compass on one end point of the given line segment. Now you have to measure this line segment and pencil that it should be more than half. So you can take a guess that this is more than half, correct? So if it is more than half, you have to now keep the pointer here on one end point of the line segment, and then you have to draw the arc on either side of the line, on both the side, up and down in the similar manner. Now you change the pointer's position, let it move to the second end point of the given line segment, and then you have to cut the same arc which you have drawn. Make sure that you are not changing the length of this pencil and the needle's distance. Okay, now what you're going to do, you got two intersecting points here, one is here and the another one is here. What you're going to do, you're going to join it. Okay, so here we have joined both the intersecting points with the help of one line. Now this line is actually perpendicular to the line, this is sure, right? Now let us make sure that whether the given line segment is being divided or is being halved or not. It has been divided into two equal parts or not. So this is the scale, and as earlier I have taken 10 centimeter line, so definitely if this is a bisector, it will cut the 10 centimeter into two equal parts, so the line will come at 5. Now let us see whether it is 5 or not. Okay, you can see that this is exactly at 5. Could see that means this line is perpendicular as well as the bisector of the line. I hope, student, you understood what does it mean. Okay, so let us move ahead. Students, now we come to draw a circle and show radius, diameter and chord of it. Now this is one circle already drawn for you. Now as you know, this is called the center of the circle. Okay, so when you are drawing a circle with the known radius and wherever you are putting this pointer, that pointer makes one hole on the paper, right? Now that is actually the center of the circle. Now if you draw one line from the center to the boundary of the circle, you understood, when you are drawing one line which is actually starting with the center and ending on the circumference or the border of the circle, this line segment is called what? You know, this is called radius. So let us write down रेडियस. नाउ व्हेन यू ड्रॉ वन लाइन विच इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम वन बॉर्डर टू अनदर बॉर्डर, ओके, एंड हैविंग द सेंटर इन बिटवीन, दैट मीन्स एग्जैक्टली एट द सेंटर. यू अंडरस्टूड? सो वॉट विल हैपन? सो वेन यू गोइंग टू ड्रॉ द लाइन फ्रॉम वन बॉर्डर टू अदर बॉर्डर, वॉट विल हैपन? द सेंटर विल बी देयर ऑन द लाइन एंड इट विल बी एग्जैक्टली एट द मिडल ऑफ दिस लाइन. सो वॉट इज दिस लाइन कॉल्ड? इज यू कैन ड्रॉ एनी हाउ. सी इफ यू आर गोइंग टू ड्रॉ लाइक दिस ऑल्सो, राइट, इट विल बी स्ट्रेट, राइट. दिस इज ऑल्सो सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ दिस लाइन. सो वॉट इज दिस लाइन कॉल्ड? इज इट इज कॉल्ड एज डायामीटर. ओके, सो दिस इज द डायामीटर, दिस इज द रेडियस. दैट मीन्स डायामीटर इज हैविंग टू रेडियस, हियर वन रेडियस एंड हियर वन रेडियस. सो द मेजरमेंट ऑफ रेडियस इफ इट इज 5 सेंटीमीटर, सो द मेजरमेंट ऑफ डायामीटर विल बी वॉट, यू नो, 5 + 5 = 10 सेंटीमीटर. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ लेट अस सी वॉट इज द कॉर्ड. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वॉट डज अ कॉर्ड मीन्स? द कॉर्ड इज एक्चुअली हैविंग one line which is joining both the borders of the circle, but you know it never takes the center on it. It could be anyhow. See, like this also may come the cord. Now here the center is here, correct? Center does not come on the line, but yes, the end points are on the border of the line. So what you can call this as? These are the cord of the circle. Understood, student? I hope you understood. Okay, so a circle has a radius, the diameter, which has the center on the diameter. The chord is any line segment which is actually having two end points on the circumference of the circle. Okay, students? Thank you, students, for watching the video. I hope you have understood how to draw a line perpendicular to another line through a point which is not on the line. Secondly, you also learned how to draw a perpendicular bisector of the given line segment, and you also came to know about what are the radius, diameter and chord of the circle. We are going to meet soon with another video. Till then, have a nice day ahead. Goodbye.